The application equipment that may be used by most landscape professionals is relatively simple. Those holding some certificates, like the limited commercial landscape maintenance certificate, may not use power equipment. Therefore, it is limited to portable handheld compressed air sprayers having no more than a 5-gallon capacity. In some circumstances, the use of a granular applicator may be appropriate for applications to plant beds. I'm Dr. DeBusk, and this video will discuss the types of equipment used by professional applicators to ornamental plant beds. Three common types of compressed air sprayers for landscape pesticide applications are backpack sprayers, handheld tank sprayers, and spray bottles. All are extremely useful for small jobs where only a few gallons or less of material are needed. Generally, these sprayers hold a pint to 3 gallons of water. Compressed air sprayers are effective and commonly used for directed, selective applications. All these types work on the same principle. The user rapidly pushes and pulls a plunger on the top or side of the tank, much like the plunger on a bicycle tire pump. The force of the plunger pumps air into the empty space inside the tank and compresses it. When the space is full of air, it becomes nearly impossible to push the plunger into the tank. At this point, the tank is pressurized. As the air pressure inside the tank drops, the amount of liquid being expelled through the nozzle also decreases. Therefore, it is important to maintain a constant pressure inside the sprayer by pumping it regularly during application. Sprayers used only for applying herbicides must be clearly labeled and used only for that purpose. Never use more than one type of pesticide in a sprayer. That is, use one for herbicides and a separate one for fungicides and insecticides. This is because residual herbicides sprayed on ornamental plants can cause damage. Label each sprayer for its intended type of pesticide. The cost of an extra sprayer is nominal compared to the replacement cost of valuable landscape plants, and the cost is not the only inconvenience. It may take years for replacement plants to reach maturity. A flat fan, even distribution tip, or adjustable cone nozzle may be used on a compressed air sprayer. Even distribution tips minimize drift by eliminating smaller droplets on the outside of the spray pattern. An adjustable cone nozzle provides the advantage of going from a broad coverage to a stream for increasing reach. Flat fan tips vary in their spray angle and rate of output and can be chosen based on the area of coverage desired. A tip with a spray angle of 15 to 40 degrees that delivers 0.3 to 0.5 gallons per minute, GPM, rated at 40 pounds per square inch, PSI, is a good choice for most applications. Spray product catalogs will explain their coding for determining angle and output. For example, spraying systems TP1502 and TP1503 have a spray angle of 15 degrees and deliver 0.2 and 0.3 GPM, respectively. TP2502 and 2503 have a spray angle of 25 degrees and deliver 0.2 and 0.3 GPM, respectively, at 40 PSI. Spray tips may be installed in the spray wand that comes with the backpack sprayer, or a spray gun may be attached. A spray gun with both a flat fan tip and cone nozzle can be used to add versatility, but this adds weight and required maintenance to the unit. The spray gun can immediately be switched from one spray tip to the other by rotating the spray head. Backpack sprayers are carried on the user's back, held by adjustable shoulder straps that allow the weight of the tank to be distributed evenly. A hose extends from the bottom of the tank around one side of the user. Attached to the hose is a spray wand with a trigger mechanism that the user squeezes to expel the tank mixture. Many backpack sprayers are equipped with a pump lever that extends from the bottom of the equipment around one side of the user. This permits the applicator to pump the sprayer regularly with one hand while moving the spray wand with the other hand. This maintains the pressure inside the tank and keeps the flow rate uniform. The nozzle tip on backpack sprayers can usually be adjusted to create various spray patterns. This important feature allows the user to select the pattern most appropriate for uniform coverage of a target weed, plant, etc. A hollow cone tip, which expels spray in a circular pattern, is often the best choice for spraying shrubs or other plants. The only real difference between a handheld tank sprayer and a backpack sprayer is how it is carried by the user. A handheld tank sprayer typically holds 1 to 3 gallons of liquid and is carried in one hand while operating the spray wand with the other. When the pressure inside the sprayer begins to decrease, the user must set the sprayer down and pump it. As with backpack sprayers, handheld sprayers come with adjustable nozzles. When only a small amount of pesticide is needed, such as for spot treating a few weeds in a plant bed, you might prefer a small bottle sprayer similar to those in which window cleaning products are sold. Empty spray bottles are available at discount and department stores as well as garden centers. Purchase one that has an adjustable nozzle that will allow you to select the setting most appropriate for the job at hand. Label the sprayer in large letters for the product used, and always store it in a locked facility with other pesticide products and equipment. Do not use a bottle that has previously held or is labeled for any other product. When dealing with very small quantities of pesticide, there is no room for error. It is important to carefully measure the amount of pesticide that you want to put into a bottle sprayer. Too little or too much pesticide concentrate can render your application useless or disastrous. Since it's usually not practical to calibrate a bottle sprayer, you must estimate the total amount of product needed for a job, and it is important to use the entire quantity mixed. Never save and store pesticide products that have been mixed with water. They lose their potency over time. Pressure is created in a bottle sprayer based on its design. In one type, pressure is created by squeezing a trigger on the lid. A similar model has a lid with a small pump and handle with a trigger. On each model, each time the trigger is squeezed, pressure forces a small amount of liquid through the nozzle. There are advantages and disadvantages with compressed air sprayers. Compressed air sprayers are portable. Backpack and handheld compressed air sprayers allow the user to move about freely. They're efficient. Compressed air sprayers allow more precision than larger equipment in treating individual or small groups of plants. Their flexibility is a plus. Adjustable nozzles and interchangeable nozzle tips allow the applicator to select the spray pattern most appropriate for the job. They're easy to use and affordable. Most tank sprayers are moderately priced, $20 and up. Factors that affect price are the material they're made of, plastic, brass, or stainless steel, features such as adjustable nozzle tips and pressure gauges, size, and overall quality. Compressed air sprayers allow precise direction of the spray. A predictable spray pattern permits the user to accurately place the product where it is needed, such as between plants or shrubs in an ornamental bed. They're durable. When maintained according to the manufacturer's instructions, compressed air sprayers will last for many years. Individual parts usually can be obtained, permitting repair rather than replacement when this sprayer malfunctions. The following are the disadvantages. The usefulness of compressed air sprayers is limited. Due to their small tank capacity, they are inefficient for treating large areas or large groups of plants. Experience governs effectiveness. The user has to develop a feel for the amount of pressure that must be maintained to ensure uniform and complete coverage. Backpack and handheld compressed air sprayers generally require maintenance. Proper maintenance is essential. Compressed air sprayers are cumbersome. Lifting and carrying a full compressed air sprayer, especially a backpack sprayer, can result in muscle strain and fatigue. Granular applicators are another one of the staple pieces of equipment used by the green industries to make fertilizer and pesticide applications. Because it is not practical to push a drop or rotary sprayer in restricted areas, such as beds of flowers and ornamental plants, smaller hand-cranked handheld units are available. Several types of hand-cranked granular applicators are available. The least expensive type has a small hopper and is held with one hand while cranking with the other. Large belly grinder units are carried on a strap around the operator's neck. Two other variations include broadcasting granules both left or right, or broadcasting primarily to one side. For some applications, it is easiest to walk along one side of the plant bed and throw material in only one direction. The hopper on the hand crank spreader may be a plastic container or a cloth bag. The pattern may or may not be adjustable, but there should always be a rate adjustment that may be combined with the on-off control. A good, even pattern depends on the skill and consistency of the operator. There are advantages and disadvantages with hand-cranked, handheld granular spreaders. The advantages include the following. Areas containing restrictions, such as landscape plants and flowers in ornamental beds, can be treated with granules, whereas a drop or rotary spreader would not have access. Low maintenance is required. Most hand-cranked, handheld spreaders are manufactured primarily from plastic parts, which eliminate rust problems. They are easy to clean with a hose after each use. Be sure to lubricate any metal parts with a light oil after cleaning. These granular spreaders are compatible with many products. They permit the use of many different products, including some that have large granules. The primary disadvantage of hand-cranked handheld spreaders is that it is difficult to achieve a uniform pattern of spread. The most important factors affecting the distribution pattern and dose include walking and cranking speed, swath width, rudder setting, amount of granule in the hopper, spreader output setting, wind speed, and walking patterns. Equipment instructions are sometimes misplaced or thrown away, which is unfortunate because you may not remember all there is to know about equipment that you use infrequently. Instructions should be kept for reference when cleaning, maintaining, and calibrating the equipment. Keep instructions in a safe place where they can be accessed easily and quickly. An example would be to maintain a reference file box for these and other home appliance and tool manuals. If instructions are printed directly on the equipment, copy them onto a piece of paper and store it in the box. These references are just as important for refreshing the memory of an experienced user as they are in getting the beginner started. In this video, hopefully you learned a bit more about the type of application equipment needed by landscape professionals. The next step for these pieces of equipment is to make sure they are properly calibrated.